Hello, everyone. Good evening, morning to all of you. Thanks for joining in. I'm just loving the energy here. I'm Bhushan Gavle, joining from Pune, India. And this is the first time for me here in the community call. So very excited to meet all of you and be part of this amazing community. I work with Rapid Circle as a solution specialist and lead the data and AI capability for India. I'm also a Microsoft MVP in the AI platform category. Today, I am also joined by my amazing colleague, Srishti. So I'll quickly hand it over to Srishti to introduce herself, and then I'll take it back again.
Thank you so much, Bhushan. I already like the vibe of the community. It's going amazing. So quickly introducing myself, I am Srishti. I've been working with Rapid Circle as senior consultant. Going ahead, been an MVP for 3 years. This year, been renewed in M365 Copilot. So a lot of amazing work coming in Copilot and Copilot Studio. Can't wait to try my hands on that. But yeah, over to you back, Bhushan.
Awesome. Thank you, Srishti. So moving on with the solution that we have tried to build, but let's first understand the problem context here. So just to make you guys aware, so when basically an organization builds a product or a service and then decides to productionize that, the job is only half done, as they usually say. Because orgs usually want to engage with their users and customers to gather the feedback, insights, know about issues, et cetera, to make their products or services better. So the typical way to do that is by exposing maybe a shared email box where customers can relay their feedback, report different issues, and someone essentially ends up monitoring that email box, goes through those emails, tries to understand the issue, analyzes, categorizes it as known as triage, and then ensures that the issue is logged into some ITSM tool internally, and then end users are acknowledged as well. Typically, this works fine, but then this is still a manual approach, cannot scale really well. So you can just imagine this, hundreds of emails dropping into inbox every single day, and each of the email, the support executives or the support staff has to handle all of them manually. Now, this is not only time consuming, but also a bit risky. Basically, in short, you are at the mercy of whoever is looking and analyzing those critical and important feedbacks that your end users are trying to report to you. That defines the shape of your product and the roadmap as well. Because this is all manual, this leads to slower resolutions. Your end users are waiting, frustrated to hear the feedback or hear more about the issues that they have reported, know about the status and the progress, etc. So the support teams also end up essentially getting burned out because of this process. So that's the pain area that we are trying to solve here with this solution. So moving on with the next slide. So let's take a look at the agentic solution at high level. For those who are new to AI or agent ecosystem, in simple terms, think of your agents as your new hires or peers. On their first day, you would usually need to instruct them. That is to make them aware of their duties, as known as instructions, and then make them aware of all the knowledge repositories. We can call this activity as onboarding them, right? And then equipping them with the tools through which they can take actions independently, operate independently, as known as tools. So stitching these concepts back in the context of this solution, think of this autonomous agent as your autonomous coworker that handles the triage process end to end. So instead of humans or team of humans spending hours on repetitive work, the AI agent can do it for us. So it seamlessly integrates with platforms that you already use, Azure DevOps for this instance, for issue tracking in this case, Outlook for email monitoring, And of course, this can be extended easily to other LOB systems. By the way, this is just this isn't just about bugs or issues. The same approach or principle can be applied for feature requests, incident management, and many other use cases in typical product ALM. So what's the biggest impact here? As you can guess already, it removes that repetitive manual work for us. This also ensures the accuracy and consistency and scales extremely effortlessly. In short, auto triage AI enables us or teams to focus on solving the problems instead of spending their energy and time in managing those different tickets that they receive. All right, so with that context, I'll move on to the next slide. So let's see how this actually works. So what you see here on the screen is it starts with a product or a service user raising that issue over an email. So instead of support agent manually reading and logging the details, the first AI agent that you see at the top here is responsible for monitoring or listening to that email box. It automatically also extracts all the relevant information from the email body. So it could be things like users are reporting some steps through which the issue can be reproduced, system details, any metadata of the issue, or description of the issue. It then creates the structured bug or issue in Azure DevOps by leveraging the knowledge that it has. So if you remember the knowledge part, so the knowledge could be elaborative product guides that the agent is aware of. It could be common troubleshooting steps documentation. It could be standard operating procedure guidelines that you can feed in. It could be product or service specification or installation guides, et cetera, that it can take a look at and refer to before it decides to do the actual triage, define the severity, priority of the issue before it actually creates an item in the DevOps for you. Once this is done, then it sends a templated acknowledgement email back to the user with some interaction or the reference ID. And this is the triage stage one that is completed. And again, that is completely automated. Now let's take a look at what happens when you have this user who is typically going to reply or ask for follow-up information if users wants to send any additional details to the previous issue that they have reported. They can still do that. They can still respond to that email, right, which the first agent has sent out. So traditionally, this would require, again, someone to go back, find that issue in the DevOps that they might have logged, find the details, update it, and again respond to the user who reported that. So if you look at the second agent here, so this is where it steps in. It picks up the tracking ID from the subject line, fetches the corresponding issue from DevOps, updates it with new information if it needs to, and then it decides to send out the confirmation email as well. It can also include the current issue status in the reply. So in short, these two specialized AI agents work together very well. So for initial triage and one for follow-up. And as you can already guess, together they are eliminating the repetitive manual steps, ensuring accuracy, providing seamless experience for both support teams as well as to the users. Now with that, I think let me hand it over to Shrushti, who can walk us all through the parts, what everyone is looking forward to see it all in action. So Shrushti, take it away, over to you.
Thank you so much. Let me just quickly share my screen. And considering the time, I'll keep it as crisp and short as possible. So let me know once you can see the screen. And let me also zoom in a bit. Yeah.
Yeah, screen's okay. Visible. Looks great. Thank you, Shrushti.
Perfect. Thank you so much. So as already elaborated by Bhushan, I'm not going to reiterate on that again. We have built two agents, and these two agents are fully autonomous in nature. There is currently no human in the loop, given there is no decision power or nothing is done by agent as of now. We are just utilizing agents at their best, wherein we are creating issue, we are assigning it, we are trying to fetch almost everything as possible just from that email or from the user feedback. So consider that same scenario. What I have done is there is an email. We are working as part of Power Automate product team, just to give an example. And Power Automate product team has received an email, something like this, saying that, hey, my Power Automate keeps failing with some issue and this is the timeout. All these details have been received. Now the first agent, as we elaborated, two agents. First is the triage one, which goes ahead, listens out to the email, fetches all the information, assigns the priority severity based on the email body and creates a ticket or creates a bug or issue or a feature based on the nature of the email in the DevOps board, and also send the acknowledgement email to that user saying that, hey, we have received your feedback or your issue and our support team is working on it. So this is the simple nature of the first agent. So if you can see the agent and just look at the beauty of instructions. So here in the agent, we mentioned it is autonomous in nature. So no code was involved, but everything, whatever instructions we have noted down, that works as part of the code and validations. So these are the detailed instructions along with the instructions and the tools, which is like DevOps connector and then using AI prompt to go through that email, fetch the details in JSON format, and then sending out the email, email as an acknowledgement. Everything is done by agent. So let me just quickly trigger this. And in the meantime, while this runs, the same email it will run on. So let me just quickly give you a minute. Okay. Yes, let me just check the timestamp so that I don't miss out. Perfect. It will run, and once it is done running, probably it will take a few seconds. Yeah, it's already there. You just zoom out. So if you can see, it's already working, and what it does is it goes to the AI prompt and it tries to fetch all the details as mentioned. It tries to craft an email body as well. And then it tries to create a work item. So I'll quickly go to my DevOps board. I'll go back. And it created a new work item. Right now, this is my test workspace. So just ignore all these similar repetitive issues logged here. It automatically created a work item here with its reason, with priority, everything. And I also received an email saying that with the templated email along this works same, whatever instructions we have provided, it works along that line. And it responded with a templated email saying that, okay, this is your tracking ID. If you want to track it further, this is the issue which we have logged or the feature request, and keep patience. We'll work on it soon and we'll get back to you. Now, coming back to the other agent, wherein I'm very enthusiastic and I want to, probably I'm facing some issues at my org and I want that issue to be solved, or I want that product team to give me some feedback or some status on, okay, what is exactly going on. So I drop an email again to the team. So this is how that email looks like. Wait. It should be there somewhere. Okay, so you can consider I've sent out an email saying that, hey, I need some more details, and that particular email might have some repro steps or some further investigation which I've done. And that email, that other agent comes into the picture. This is that other agent. Again, it works in the similar fashion, autonomous in nature, looks into the email. And then if you see the instructions, it's almost same, but the instructions are pretty different because here we are performing a different set of tasks. What here we are doing is how to track that particular ticket. So for that, we always look out for the tracking ID. And as mentioned by Bhushan, that the person who already have sent out the acknowledgement, they also see that the tracking ID, wherein they can send out the, again, email with the same tracking ID. And that is how we fetch the details of the status, who is assigned to, what is going on their ticket which was raised. So again, similar set of instructions in detail and the tools. Tools are again somewhat similar, but here what we are doing is we are trying to update the details if the user has shared some more repro steps or whatever they have performed to, you know, replicate the issue which they are facing. So we update that as well in the work item. We fetch that work item by going through the task ID. So again, using AI prompt to fetch the work item ID or task item ID, and then go into the DevOps and then fetch the details, update them, and then reply and send out an email on the status. So this is what is done by the autonomous agent number two, which is just a follow-up agent. And quickly, if I have to test that again, so let me just quickly test. It runs in the similar fashion, and I'll quickly come to one another important point. Just a second, let me just run this. Okay, it was 45. I'm relying on God that I picked up the right email. Perfect. So what I'm missing here is one thing. Whenever we work as part of product team, we also have a huge documentation. So my bad, I picked up the wrong one. I won't waste time there. But let me quickly fetch the latest run. So we also look out for the documentation. We have detailed documentation for any product or feature which we are working on. So if by any chance our agent wants to answer some responses or some resolution steps, even in the email along with the acknowledgement, we can do that as well via the documentation. So we have detailed documentation added as knowledge, and that works like charm. You can provide any instruction saying that based on the issue which was raised, do you see any resolution steps from the documentation, and also use that resolution steps and provide it in the email, and that also works. And you can also add a resolution in your work item saying that this resolution was sent to the user and they might respond back that it worked, or maybe they are still facing the issue. That works as well. So we are using documentation also as knowledge. And this is the second agent, which updates the item, which sends an email, replies, and then looks into the task ID and also get. So this is the work pattern at which works. And this is fully autonomous in nature, as mentioned. But this is how we have built the auto AI triage agent. And this can also be worked. This we can also have implemented with agent-to-agent, multi-agent orchestration, which is just recently released. But this work we did some months back, wherein there was no way to call another agent from an agent. But yeah, I mean, these are the two standalone agents, which are currently working parallelly and only working autonomously, looking into the email inboxes and working seamlessly with DevOps. This ITSM system can be anything like your ServiceNow or Jira or whatever you have in place in your organization, and you can fit this exactly piece of work wherever you want. So this is what we worked on, and I hope this is useful for a few of you, and maybe you can take this up, take the inspiration and build something else on top of it. But to close on, we have observed some really good benefits from the same. But won't dive into it much. But as mentioned, that it reduces the effort of support team as well. And also, it reduces the layer wherein AI is doing a part for the human, the tedious manual task wherein creating the items, assigning the priority, which it can do very easily. So that's it from me. Anything you want to add, Bhushan, before we hand over to David?
No, I think. Thank you for that, Shrishti. I think this is all we wanted to demonstrate. So over to you again, David.